Cilnidipine is a calcium channel blocker primarily used to treat hypertension or high blood pressure by helping to lower blood pressure and reduce cardiovascular risks. Chronic kidney disease in hypertensive patients, as it provides kidney protection by reducing proteinuria. Hypertension with tachycardia, due to its unique action on both L-type and N-type calcium channels, which can help reduce heart rate. Cilnidipine is generally well tolerated, but common side effects include dizziness, headache, fatigue, flushing, and mild peripheral edema, which is less frequent compared to amlodipine. Less common side effects like hypotension, bradycardia due to N-type blockade, nausea, and palpitations. Cilnidipine is a dual L-type and N-type calcium channel blocker. The L-type blockade leads to vasodilation by relaxing vascular smooth muscles, thereby reducing blood pressure. The N-type blockade reduces sympathetic nerve activity, preventing excessive heart rate increase. This dual action makes cilnidipine distinct from other calcium channel blockers and contributes to a lower incidence of reflex tachycardia and pedal edema. The typical dosage ranges from 5 to 20 mg once daily, taken orally. The usual starting dose is 10 mg once daily. The maximum recommended dose is 20 mg per day. It is preferably taken in the morning, with or without food. Cilnidipine can interact with various medications. Other antihypertensives, such as beta blockers, ACE inhibitors, and ARBs, which can enhance its hypotensive effects. Diuretics, which may cause excessive lowering of blood pressure. CYP3, A4 inhibitors, like ketoconazole and erythromycin, which can increase cilnidipine levels. CYP3 A4 inducers, such as rifampin and carbamazepine, which may reduce its effectiveness. Grapefruit juice, which can interfere with its metabolism and lead to increased drug concentration. Certain precautions should be considered when using cilnidipine. It carries a risk of hypotension and should be avoided in patients prone to low blood pressure. Use with caution in patients with severe heart failure. Its safety during pregnancy and lactation is not well established, so it should be avoided unless necessary. Dose adjustments may be needed for patients with liver disease. Elderly patients should start with a lower dose due to a higher risk of dizziness and falls. And that's all for this video. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video.